Children, good morning. How are you all? I hope you are all safe at home. Children, we have completed 2 units in your grade 4 syllabus. Okay, let's start unit number 3 today. The name of the unit is Light Years Ahead. In this unit, we are going to read about a genius and his great ideas. We are going to use words to measure nouns. We are going to learn how to focus on action in the sentence. Okay, children. In today's class, we are going to read about a genius. Okay. Who is a genius? A genius is a man or a woman who has intelligent or great ideas. Okay, about which genius we are going to discuss in this lesson, children? Shall we see? Okay, before going to the lesson, let me ask you some questions. Okay, these are some household devices we use in our house. Okay, these devices consume electricity. So without these, without electricity, we cannot use these devices. Okay. Where do we get electricity from? We get electricity from water resources, from windmills. These windmills extract electricity, they produce electricity from air. Then we use solar panels for producing electricity. Then there are some thermal power stations. Thermal power stations means thermal means heat. So with the heat energy, electricity is produced in some places like Neyveli. You know that, right? Then nuclear power stations, with the nuclear energy electricity is produced. Likewise, these are the some sources of electricity, how electricity is produced. Okay, as I said, we are going to read about a genius. Can you guess who is this genius? Yeah, he is none other than Nikola Tesla. Who is Nikola Tesla? Where was he born? Let us see. Nikola Tesla is a great inventor and he was born on 10th July 1856 in Smiljan in Austrian Empire. Okay. In modern day, it is called as Croatia. Okay. He lived for nearly 86 years and he died on January 7, 1943. In New York City. This city is in United States, USA, right? Children, now let us discuss some of the incidents that happened in Nikola Tesla's life, okay? Okay, the name of this lesson is The Electrifying Life of Nikola Tesla, okay? He was a great inventor, right? He invented many devices which works under electricity, okay? He was a scientist, an inventor, a genius, Nikola Tesla. Okay, the man behind the electrical system we all use today. Nowadays, as I said before, each and every appliances of our home works in electricity. The cell phone we use, the laptop, mixie, grinder, everything. For everything we need electricity. Okay. We saw how do we get electricity from it. What are the sources also, okay. But before that, some of the scientists worked hard for those inventions, right? So one of those scientists is Nikola Tesla. Okay, as I said, he was born in Smiljan, Croatia in 1856. Tesla was one of the 5 children. Okay, his parents had 5 children. And one of those is Tesla. Okay. Tesla. See, now listen to the second point. See,
Tesla got his scientific curiosity from his mother. Okay, let us see who is his mother. This is Tesla's mother. Her name is Yuka Tesla. So she was constantly inventing small household appliances. Okay, so his mother was was his role model, it seems. She was also doing some inventions for her household things. Okay, she was doing some inventions, and Tesla loved science and math. Just while going to school, his favorite subjects were science and math. He had many ideas for inventing machines that ran on electricity. In his early childhood itself, he had an aim to become a scientist. Okay, so he had some ideas while we grow up, how we have to become, what are the inventions we have to do, like that. He had some future plans in his mind. He was thinking, someday I'll go to America. Okay, now at present, he was living in Austria. Okay, he was thinking to go to America. Someday I'll go to America and use the power of Niagara Falls to generate electricity. Okay, as I said, there are some sources for producing electricity. One of the sources is water power. Okay, so the Niagara waterfalls, from the power of Niagara waterfalls, he had an idea for generating electricity. Okay, this is Niagara waterfalls, children. This is in America as well as in Canada. Okay, so in his early childhood, he had the dream. Okay, so let's go to the fourth point. In 1884, Tesla arrived in New York with a very little money. So he had a very strong aim. So he went there to New York. New York is a place in America. Okay, so with very little money and a letter of introduction to the inventor Thomas Edison. Do you know who is this person, Thomas Edison? Have you heard about Thomas Alva Edison, children? Okay, he is Mr. Thomas Alva Edison. He is also one of the great inventors. He invented electric bulb. Okay, so with that introduction letter, he went to Thomas Alva Edison. Okay, so after he went there, Thomas Alva Edison said, okay, Thomas Alva Edison was a famous scientist who said to have invented the electric bulb. Okay, so I like this clever young man. Edison hired him means he gave job to him on the same day. Okay, he was given job by Edison. Then Edison began to work on a system that would distribute electricity to all homes and businesses. Okay, that was the time when scientists were just discovering what is electricity and how to make use of that electricity. Like that, they were just discovering. The homes were without electric bulb, without mixer grinder or any electric appliances. Only lamps were used on those days. So this man Edison had an idea to bring electricity to all the houses and to the businesses. Okay, then he built power plants based on direct current system. Okay, power plants means this is the place where electricity is produced. Okay, direct current means the current will be in this form. Okay, so this is direct current. Okay, we use chargers for mobile phones, right? For those chargers, make use of direct current. Okay, one power plant was built almost every kilometer. For one each kilometer, a power plant means a place where electricity is produced. So the current would pass from one plant to another, which would then connect to the homes. Okay, So, from one power plant to another, electricity will be passed and homes will be making use of that electricity. This was his plan. Okay. Tesla worked hard at Edison's company. He improved several machines that Edison has designed. Just Edison gave some ideas. This is my design. You have to do like that. He gave work to Tesla. Tesla worked hard and he also improved several machines. Okay. If you improve on my DC system, I will give you $50,000. This was the deal made by Edison. So you have to work for me. If you work for me, I'll pay for you. Like that, he made a deal with Tesla. Okay, Edison. Then what happened? After several months, Tesla came with alternating current system. This is only alternating current system. That means the current will be passing in this zigzag manner. So it was cheaper and better than DC. Also, this alternative current can pass to many kilometers. If we build a DC power plant now, for 1 kilometer we have to build a power plant. But for AC current, we can carry for even more kilometers also. Okay. And could carry electricity for longer distances. So he made a change in this power production. Who? Tesla made a change. So he was waiting for the reward, the $50,000 reward. Okay. So, but this was not liked by Thomas Alva Edison. Edison refused to pay him. He said, no, I will not give you any money like that. He did not want an alternative to his DC system. Okay. This DC system idea is Edison's idea. This AC system idea is Tesla's idea. Okay, so this Tesla's idea is now better than that. So people will be buying more. So this Edison don't like that. Okay, he became angry on Tesla. Now while he was asking money, while Tesla was asking money, I have worked for you this long time. You have to pay for me like that. He was asking money. I was only joking about that. He didn't pay anything. He said, I was only joking to pay you like that. He just deceived. Deceived means he cheated Tesla. He didn't pay anything. Okay. Then let's see what happened. So, there arises a cold war. Okay. War of currents. This AC current and DC current. Between two scientists, there was a fight going on between Nikola Tesla and Thomas Alva Edison. He was telling that now Tesla is telling your DC model is weak and expensive. Expensive means costly. Now Edison is replying, you are talking rubbish. AC models are dangerous. Tesla and Edison did not agree on many things. They were fighting. Okay, even though they were scientists, they were fighting among themselves. Okay, let's see the next point. Tesla left Edison's company. He left that place. He just quit his job and he went away from Edison and started working on AC system of electricity, which became popular. Now he worked on his own project. Okay, now Edison tried to turn people against Tesla system. Now he don't like Tesla, right? So Edison said to people that this is not a good idea. You don't buy those things like that. He was turning people against Tesla. But it didn't work. The AC model started being used widely. Okay, whatever he planned to pull down Tesla didn't work. This AC system was used widely. Widely means by many people, and used even today. Even today we use AC currents in our houses. Okay, the AC system should be banned. It can kill people like that. These were the things said by Edison, but that was not true. Okay. So Tesla fought back. While Edison was telling the bad things about Tesla, he said, see, this is perfectly safe. Tesla fought back. He showed AC was safe by allowing electricity to run through his body. See, he connected electricity with his body and he showed. Okay, even now we use many electrical equipments even in our hospitals. If the patient is admitted in a serious condition, okay, even for coronavirus disorder also, okay. So, this AC current is used in this hospital equipments also. Do you know our human body also have electric current? Okay. So, he connected wires across his body. Then he light up a lamp and he showed that, he proved that his AC current was perfectly safe. At last, Tesla's childhood dream came true. He used his AC model to build a power plant at Niagara Falls. Okay, so power plant means, as I said, a place for generating electricity. Using the water power from the Niagara Falls, we can generate electricity. This was his idea. It is used in India also in many places, children. So this is the power plant, hydroelectric power plant created by Nikola Tesla. Do you guess what is this place? Can you guess? Okay, this place is located in NATO. This is an atomic hydropower station. Oh, sorry. This is a hydropower station located in Meitu. Okay. Tesla's next brilliant invention was Tesla coil. Okay. This is an image of Tesla coil, children. So this is a wireless technology. Okay, this could light up bulbs even without wires. Now we use wireless cell phones, laptops and so on, and many appliances also. Okay, so this Tesla's coil forms the basic idea. Okay, so this Tesla coil formed the basis for today's wireless technology. This means the gadget can be powered up without using wires. We can use batteries also, and we can work those appliances like that. It is designed. Okay, there was more brilliant inventions from Tesla, but he did not get credit for many of them. He invented many things, but most of the time he did not get enough reward for that. So the radio, the X-ray, the radar and the robotics. Now in modern day, robotics is improving now. This Tesla formed the basis for that, laid the base for that robotics also. Okay, let us see some of the inventions of Tesla. This is the AC power station. So he invented Tesla experimental station, Tesla's oscillator, Tesla turbine, Tesla valve, and many other things like this. Also, he used wireless power transfer. Nowadays we use Wi-Fi technology also, right? So Tesla laid the foundation for everything. Not only this, children, many things were invented by Tesla, but he did not get enough credit for his inventions. So Tesla said his ideas with the while he was sharing his idea, knowingly or unknowingly, many scientists used his ideas for X-rays and for radios. Many scientists steal his ideas and they made inventions based on his ideas. Okay, so they became the inventors of those things, even though Tesla had come up with the things first. So using Tesla's ideas, they created this radio, X-ray, or many things. Many scientists used his ideas. Tesla didn't care about it. I don't care that they stole my ideas. I care that they didn't have one of their own. He was not caring that they steal my ideas. So only they became very great inventors like that. He didn't care about that. They don't have any idea of thinking of their own. So they steal my ideas like that. He was just walking away. Okay. In 1901, Tesla set up a huge means very big electrical tower to transmit free electricity to people all over the world. Okay, children, nowadays we are getting in some places, if we go to shopping malls or theaters or wherever, we get free Wi-Fi. Okay, a small tower will be set, and from that we use internet. Likewise, Tesla was making an idea to give electricity to the whole world. Okay, then he also believed that the tower could even communicate with the outer space. So with the help of that tower, they can communicate to the space also. For space research also it could be used. Like that he was thinking. However, the project was failed. Made an idea, but it was failed. So Tesla was deeply disappointed. Okay, Tesla was a genius. It is said that he could memorize the entire books, speak 8 languages, and build machines straight from his imagination. What he is thinking, he can. With that imagination, he could invent that machine. Okay. So without writing anything down, okay, without just what he is thinking, we will be writing some notes how it could be designed like that. Okay, many other inventors also will be writing something, but he didn't do anything. Whatever he is thinking, he will be doing even without taking notes also. Okay, he could, as I said, he could speak 8 languages. So such a genius man was Tesla. Okay. Nikola Tesla died at the age of 86. As I said, he was died in New York. Although he may not be remembered as the inventor of many things we use today, he is still the man who lit up the world. He is the man who gave light to the world. So hereafter, while we are using this household devices or electronic gadgets or anything, we have to remember Nikola Tesla. Okay.